Settled and on their way to the World Cup. The Burkinabe are perhaps the favourites of Africa's neutrals, given their Cinderella performance at AFCON 2013. Known as the Stallions, Paul Putt's men have tried on six previous occasions to reach the World Cup finals. They failed on each attempt. The team from the land known as the Home of Men with Dignity will hope to live up to that every inch when they meet Algeria. The Desert Foxes played in the 2010 World Cup for the first time in 24 years. They did so after seeing off Egypt in one of the most tense qualifier matchups in history. While Brazil marked their fourth World Cup experience, this Saturday's clash will have a strong bearing on the answer. To Abidjan we go, where the Cote d'Ivoire have maintained a steady World Cup run since breaking their 76-year drought of appearances in 2006. They narrowly qualified for Germany and breezed into South Africa 2010. All that's left for coach Sabri Lamouchi is to turn the most talented generation of Ivorians into world beaters. The Teranga Lions will be like caged canines, having embarrassed themselves by not reaching the Cup of Nations in 2013. They haven't been to the World Cup since their quarterfinal advance in 2002. The current crop of Senegalese players like Demba and Moussa Sarr will want to do it again in Brazil. They first need to get past the continent's powerhouse, the Ivory Coast. Ethiopia will be well known to South Africans. Had it not been for the Walya Antelopes, it would be Bafana vying for a place in Brazil. Coach Sonet Bishu will hope to invoke the spirit of 1962. The year in which they won the Africa Cup of Nations and made their first attempt at a World Cup spot. They failed to overcome that final hurdle, and it will be tough doing so in 2013. Standing in their way are the reigning champions of Africa. The Super Eagles may have had their off-field dramas in SA, they always do, but in the end Stephen Keshi succeeded in moulding together a blend of international and locally based players into one formidable Cup of Nations winning team. Tunisia doing well in 2013. Their top club team pushing for a spot in the finals of the African Champions League. The national team playing Cameroon looking for a spot in Brazil. They've been to the World Cup no fewer than four times. The Carthage Eagles may have only reached the group stage of the 2013 Cup of Nations, but with a 1 in 10 chance of reaching the World Cup, do not write them off. The biggest clash across Africa this weekend sees the 2010 World Cup quarterfinalists Ghana meeting Africa's most successful team at continental level, Egypt. It bears testimony to the Pharaoh's fighting spirit that they've been able to reach the penultimate stage of qualifiers despite extreme political turmoil. Last time round, they narrowly missed out on a World Cup spot to Algeria. This time round, their task not made any easier by their meeting with Africa's most successful team at the World Cup. The Black Stars have been to the last two, but even they would have hoped for an easier test in the final hurdle to reach the 2014 World Cup in Brazil. Okay, so